Hello, and welcome to part 6 of the second of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. In this part, you'll explore the Oracle Jet components and techniques relating to validation and error handling. Jet includes validators and converters on editable components. Editable components include OJ checkbox set, OJ combo box, OJ input, OJ radio set, OJ select, and OJ text area. These can be used as is, or you can customize them to include features for validating and converting data input. When you are dealing with dates, numbers, currencies, and percentages in your JET applications, be aware that there may be utilities available in JET to help you.
Let's start by comparing the standard HTML5 date picker with the date picker that Oracle JET provides. In the browser in our application, we see the standard HTML5 date picker. And we also see the Oracle Jet date picker, which uses the LTUI design system by default and therefore blends in very well with an Oracle Jet application. The amount of work needed to set up a date picker in Oracle Jet is about the same as the standard HTML5 component. However, the date picker in Oracle Jet also includes a set of options. For example, you can display the number of the week, and there are a range of other settings you can provide. In addition, there are converters to convert the value to the display that you prefer. You can see here that the month is set to long, meaning that you will get, as you can see here, December instead of the number 12, or November instead of the number 11 in the value displayed within the result of the date picker.
The converters you've seen so far can be extended with validator attributes. The validation attributes easily let you add error handling features to the conversion components to which you have already been introduced. When you need error badges for any editable components in your JET applications, look no further than JET's validation attributes. JET editable components can be supplemented with built-in validators, as well as with custom validators that you can create and develop further yourself. Application-level validation combines the techniques you have learned about in this part. More complex scenarios are shown in the JET cookbook, such as cross-field business validation between multiple fields, together with a very common requirement to track which fields in a form are valid and which are not when you submit the form. In this part, you have been introduced to attributes that you can use to set conversion and validation features on the components in your JET applications. For your homework for this part, try adding some basic input components of various types to your JET applications. Using examples from the cookbook, enable some of the built-in validators and converters. And as a bonus, you can try creating your own custom validators or converters and attach them to one of your input components. With that, we've completed part 6 of the second week, and we'll see you again in part 7.